We're trying Unkibble and our first boxes just arrived. Now I've been seeing Unkibble all over social media, I've been doing a lot of research and I'm really hoping that it helps, especially with Gemma's allergies, but also to keep all three of my dogs healthier than they are now. I have one senior dog, two puppies. I'm really excited to give this one a try. So our first boxes just arrived today. I'm gonna bring you along on the journey to see how they like it. My plan with this is to use this as partial meals for my dogs and potentially as toppers for meals for my dogs. So I still want them to have some kibble, some human food, and then some unkibble as well. We're gonna see how they like it over the next 2 weeks, and I'm gonna report back to you. Inside of our boxes for Lucy and Gemma, I did get one beef and one turkey so that we could kind of try these out. This is a week per bag. They also gave us a scoop. And the great thing about the scoop is that it has two different lines. So the bottom line is for the beef and the turkey, and the top line is for the chicken and the cod. So they are differently shaped, which means you need different amounts for each of those. And they have those four different flavors. So we went again with the turkey and with the beef. I think will be really good for my dogs. We're gonna see how they like that. We might also try the cod with them in the future. I do think I'm gonna skip chicken because of all of Gemma's allergies. We've tried to take chicken out and I don't think it's really changed her level of itchiness. So I don't think she's allergic to chicken, but I'm just gonna be extra careful with that as we are going through food choices throughout the course of her life. And so we've got the different scoops. My girls, my big girls, each need four scoops a day if they were going to solely be eating the unkibble, but we are going to be doing a mix, at least for now, to see how it works for them. We are now 10 days into our journey with Unkibble, and I'm gonna break down everything that's been going on for you and talk about what I'm planning to do in the future. Now, right now, I am still mixing the kibble and Unkibble together so that my dogs are getting some of their old food and some of their new food. And moving forward, my plan has always been, and right now is continuing to be, to do part Unkibble, part normal kibble, and part food that I am preparing for them, plus things like raw toppers and some extras to make sure they're getting a well-balanced diet. I really like the idea of making sure that I have the flexibility within their diet to do a little more or a little less, depending on the seasons, depending on what their tummies are going to be doing, depending on what they like. So I wanna be flexible with this and I wanna give them a little bit of each thing. That way it keeps the cost down. It means that I can do some cooking for them and then I have the flexibility for when we're traveling and things like that to not carry all the big bulky stuff with me. So my plan is to do a mix moving forward, but let's backtrack and talk about what's been going on. So when I ordered food, I ordered for all three of my dogs. I did the 2 week trial for each of them. For Ember, it was only allowed one bag because she's a tiny dog, so she eats less and she's an older dog. So she only gets one bag of food. She did not get to try two different flavors. Both of the big dogs, Gemma and Lucy, did get two different kinds. So I ordered a beef for each of them and a turkey for each of them. And they really, really like it. They love the unkibble over their kibble. If I put, and you guys know, if you've been following our journey, I hand feed my dog. So I take a handful at a time and put it in their bowl and let them eat that. And then I'll give them another handful. Usually we do some tricks in between because when Gemma was a puppy, she had some trouble swallowing and she would sometimes choke herself. So I had to slow everybody down. Lucy's a really fast eater as well. So I still do one handful at a time to make sure that I work with their training and I keep them at a nice slow pace. I really like having that bonding time with them as well. So I feed them one handful at a time. And when I give them unkibble and kibble, they'll pick out the unkibble, eat some of the normal kibble, and then ask for more, leaving some in the bowl, which they never do. They love their food. So they like the unkibble better than the kibble. That has worked really well for us. They like it. They enjoy it. It has helped with their poop, which is so, so nice. I really like that it has kind of made it what it's supposed to be. They're not struggling. We're not dealing with any diarrhea. We're not dealing with massive amounts of it. Well, I'm sorry. I'm trying not to be too gross here, but it is what it's supposed to be now. It is much, much better. We don't have either end of the spectrum when it comes to it being hard or it not being hard and all of those things. That's really great. What I have learned is that Gemma is allergic to beef. I've done a lot of research on this. Baby girl struggles. Baby girl struggles. If you have a dog who has allergies, So if they have skin allergies, or if you're seeing a change in their temperament, or if you are seeing them have a change in their bowel movements, or if they're throwing up, some people will suggest that perhaps they could be allergic to chicken. I actually heard a vet on social media say, not all dogs are allergic to chicken. In fact, more dogs are allergic to beef than chicken. I never knew dogs could have a beef allergy, so I started to research it because I did not have my dogs on a beef food. I, when I tried on kibble, did the beef bag and the turkey bag. And so when I gave Gemma beef, she had about two of those meals with just part of it. She didn't have very much because we were mixing it in to integrate it into the system so it wasn't hard on them. And she got sick. Her poop was not great. And she was still very itchy. You guys know she has severe skin allergies, but there's an aggression that can come with this as well. There was a whole bunch of things. If you have a dog where you're concerned about potential food allergies, look into beef. There are very specific things, and Gemma hit most of them in a very short amount of time. So she only had a couple of meals of beef, and I realized something is wrong. This is not correct. And so I did the research, and she checked most of the boxes, including the aggression. I saw a dramatic shift in her personality. She was a very grumpy baby for a couple of days. And so I immediately took her off of the beef. I like hard stopped. We did not do any beef. She had her kibble for a day or two to refresh. And then we went with the turkey. She is much better on turkey. And I saw a switch in her personality, a switch in most of the other things. We didn't have any more sickness, no more other issues. It's beef. She is allergic to beef. And so I'm really grateful that I now know this, and she will never have that again. So I'm transitioning my dogs entirely over to turkey. And turkey's a little more expensive than the beef, but we're not doing beef in this house, period. And I, to the extent where I will be checking their treats, I'm going to be checking any of the other foods that I'm giving them, no beef in this house, period. End of discussion. So Lucy's finishing up the bags of beef because we have two of them. And then I'll put her over onto the turkey as well. And again, I'm still doing a collaboration of unkibble and kibble and cooked food and then a little bit of raw food as well as we are progressing with my girls. And they're transitioning out of the puppy phase. So remember, two of my three dogs are still puppies. They're still under 1 year old. Not for very long. Lucy has a birthday coming up, but they're still under a year old. And so we're transitioning them to adult food, but also to the unkibble. And we're going to have that collaboration of those things. So I really like the unkibble because it is something I can store in my pantry. So I've got it inside of a food storage container for dogs on wheels. It's really nice. And then I'm able to just take them out. I really like that it has a scoop with very clearly marked lines on what is what. And then you can see as you go through the food, it has different size pieces, different chunks of different things. And so that's going to work really well for my girls. It's also very good for training because it's bigger. It feels more like a treat, more like some special thing that they get as opposed to the normal kibble pieces that they have. So this is going to be really nice if you're training your dog. So if you're going to be training your dog, you're doing new tricks or you're doing new tasks that you're teaching them, or if they're puppies and they're learning all this stuff new, this is a really good opportunity for you to just put it in your little silicone pouch and just hand it to them instead of a biscuit. And then that way you can put the appropriate amount of food into your pouch, or you can do less. So both of my big girls get 4 scoops a day. So I could do 1 scoop for breakfast, 1 scoop for dinner, and then 2 scoops in the pouch and train with that throughout the day as long as I'm being mindful of that. So that's going to work really well for you because it feels like an elevated treat. It feels like something that's special, a higher value reward rather than just the normal, you know, kibble that they would have for dinner. So that's going to work really well for training. I do like unkibble. That is something I do want to continue with. I like how it has helped my dog's digestive tracts. Because it's human grade food, I know that it's going to be healthier for them. It is going to help with, oh, and that was another thing with the beef. Ear allergies come out really strong with that. And Gemma has really good, clean ears most of the time. It did not look or smell nice in there while she was on the beef. And then it cleared up after. Beef allergies, man. I cannot tell you how much I'm going to study this and how much you should as well. But unkibble has worked really well for us so far. Again, we're only 10 days in. I am transitioning everybody over to turkey. So we're just getting rid of the rest of the beef that we are or that we have. Lucy's going to eat that and Ember is going to eat that. And as soon as that's done, never again will that be in my house. We're going exclusively with turkey for the unkibble. And then we're going to see about what other kibble type we are going to bring into their diet as well. And I'm going to be cooking for them too, plus a little bit of raw, some supplements, all of those things to make sure we have a healthy, well-rounded puppy as they are growing up. So I do like Unkibble. I think Unkibble is really good. Something we are going to continue with, something that I am going to continue using inside of their diet. Something I do recommend that dog parents look at if that's something that you're interested in, kind of elevating their food. It is definitely steps up from kibble, but you can use this however you want. You can use it as a topper. You can use it as the full meal. It is expensive if it's the full meal, but if you do like half and half or a third and a third, like I'm planning on doing, I think a third Unkibble, a third kibble, and then a third that I'm going to be cooking. We're going to kind of test it and see what works best for our dogs, but be mindful of the different types of food. You might need to test those out. Typically, or at least what I've seen with Spot and Tango is that they allow you to have a 2-week trial on a discount, and then you can kind of figure out what you're going to do from there. Little dogs only get one flavor that they can try. Big dogs can have more than one. Just do your research first. Pay attention to what you're already feeding your dog to transition over to it, and then don't buy too much until you know what's going to work for your dog. They did say on the packaging you have to use it within 8 weeks. So even if you don't use it for every meal every day, within 8 weeks you do have to finish up that bag or it's going to go bad. So you have to make sure that, you know, you don't order too much. They do allow you to push back those dates. So make sure if you are testing it out, you're not going to go through all of it in the 2-week trial that they're giving you. So you might want to push that back a little bit. I have pushed mine back pretty far just so I can, you know, get to that point. Right now, we have not gone through a ton of it because I have been mixing it together and because I did pull back because she had that allergic reaction to the beef. So I think I have a little bit more than most people when they go through this, but just, you know, make sure you're managing and maintaining what is going to work for you. And you can do that right on their website, which is really nice. So as a whole, I very much like Unkibble. I'm going to move forward with this. I'm going to do more with this. I am going to see how I can, you know, implement this into their diet the best way possible. I learned my lesson. My dog is allergic to beef. We will never, ever, 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 ever do that again. It checked every box, guys. It was rough. It was a rough couple of days. But as soon as I got her off of that, because she hadn't been on it for very long, it was pretty, you know, not terrible to turn that around. And I saw a dramatic difference between being on it and being off it for Gemma. Lucy had no trouble with it at all. Ember has had no trouble with it, and they really, really like it. So it's a fun one for you to implement into their diet. It's great for treats. It's great for training. It's great for leveling up their healthy food. And it's definitely something that is worth giving a try to see if it's going to work well for your dog. If there are other things that I should be trying out for you, go ahead and let me know and follow along for daily videos helping you navigate the world of being a dog parent to make this your best life possible with your pup so that you can learn lessons from us and from the experts that we're bringing onto the channel for you to get your questions answered as we help you on enrichment, your dog photo and content creation, as we help you on your dog travel and with the tools and technologies and food that will help your dog to thrive in your life. We'll see you in the upcoming episodes.